Hi guys, welcome back to Insta Guruji, where we are going to discuss about science with both RBSE and CBSE boards. मेरे को एक्चुअल में एक यहाँ पर रिक्वेस्ट आई थी, काफ़ी दिनों से आ रही थी, और ये रिक्वेस्ट थी कि इलेक्ट्रिक जो जनरेटर जो कि हमने पहले पढ़ रखा है वीडियो के अंदर, उसको इंग्लिश में पढ़ाया है। तो डेफिनेट सी बात है कि मैं अपने सारे रिक्वेस्ट को चूंकि सम्मान देता हूँ, तो उसी क्रम में मैं ये वाली वीडियो लेकर आया हूँ। उसको अपन इंग्लिश में आज जनरेटर को पढ़ेंगे। देखो, मैं इंग्लिश में अपने आपको इतना दक्ष नहीं समझता कि मैं आपको सब कुछ इंग्लिश में, इवन जो अपन अभी कन्वर्सेशन कर रहे हैं इसको भी इंग्लिश में कर सकूँ। तो इसको तो देखो मैं हिंदी में रखूँगा, लेकिन मैं आपके लिए इस वीडियो को इंग्लिश में ही शूट करने जा रहा हूँ। तो मोस्टली I will use English in this video. First of all, you know very well about generator. The device which generates electricity through mechanical energy is called electric generator. And before reading generator, you must know about magnetic field. As we have discussed in our previous videos, the magnetic field is the field around a magnet which allows another magnet to interact with it. Okay, that's all. The main thing which we should know here, we must know here about magnetic field. The direction of magnetic field is always from north pole to S pole of the magnet. Okay. The another thing which we must know about before reading this electric generator, which is magnetic flux. You know very well that the direction of magnetic field is always from N to S. If we suppose that my right side there is a north pole of magnet and my left side there is a south pole of magnet, so the direction of magnetic field is like here to there. Okay, that's it. But if I take something just like a frame, just like if I talk with this notebook, so suppose this is a frame, only frame, there is nothing inside this frame, there is only totally this is frame. You can suppose your photo frame where you remove your photo and the glass, then you will find only the least frame. From mid side there is nothing, you can put your hand this side and it comes out with this side. So this is a frame. So as we know, the direction of magnetic field is from N to S, and if I put frame like this, then you know very well the magnetic field lines will come like this and pass through this frame. But if you put this frame like this, the magnetic field lines will come and collide here and will stop here, will not pass through this frame. Okay, you know very well. Now the number of magnetic field lines passing through this frame is called magnetic flux. Okay, so this is the definition of magnetic flux, that the number of magnetic field lines which are passing through a frame, imaginary frame, into magnetic field is called magnetic flux. Okay, that's it. Now we are going to discuss about electric generator. So now we are able to discuss about electric generator. First of all, I'm going to draw the structural diagram of electric generator. Here we have two strong magnets. This is north pole of the magnet and this is the south pole of the magnet. Okay, between these two magnets I'm going to put an armature here. This is an armature and this is the axis of rotation of this armature. You know very well that armature is made of soft iron cord which is rounded by copper insulated wire. Okay, now these are two ends of that copper insulated wire and we have two rings here. This ring is named as S1 into a notebook, or you can also call it ring R1 because it is ring, so we can call it R, call it by R. Or this is our second slipped ring which is named as S2. So this is S2, this is S1. Now the one wire of the armature is connected with one ring and the another wire of this armature is connected with this second ring, not connected with this ring. This is passing behind this ring but connected with this ring S2, and both the rings are connected with this armature. As the armature rotates, these rings will also be rotated. Now we have two brushes here. This is our brush B1 which is connected with our ring S1. This is our brush B2 which is connected with our this ring S2. There are two wires for the connection with outer circuit. The galvanometer we have taken as our outer circuit. The galvanometer is a device which tells us if the current is flowing or not, or in which direction the current is flowing. Okay, so this is the basic structure of our generator. If I give it name, I can call it ABCD. Here this is our armature. Now what we have discussed yet, we are going to keep into mind and going to discuss about this. You know very well that the direction of magnetic field is from North Pole to South Pole. Very well. So recently I told you about a frame. Your armature is also just like a frame. Okay, when the armature is kept here like this, their magnetic field lines comes and collide here, and zero magnetic field line will pass through this frame. So the value of electric current will be zero. So here I'm also going to put a graph which will describe you very briefly about this. Zero magnetic field lines are passing through this frame, so the value of current is zero. But when I rotate this armature a bit with some angle, then some magnetic field lines will come and pass through with this frame. So the value of magnetic flux will increase, and the value of magnetic field will produce current in this armature. So if I rotate it like this, then some magnetic field lines will come, so the value of electric current will increase. So firstly it was zero, but now it is increased by something. When I rotate it more with more angle, then more magnetic field lines will come and pass through this surface, so the value of my electric current will be increased. Also, when I put it like this at 90 degrees of angle, then the maximum magnetic field lines will come and pass through this surface, pass through this frame, so the value of electric current will be maximum. So we are here at maximum level. But what happens when I rotate it more? When I rotate it more, it again going to with less magnetic field lines passing, because with this situation more magnetic field lines are coming and passing through this surface. But when I rotate again like this, then the values of the number of magnetic field lines will decrease, and the with the electric current is also it is connected with the directly connected with the number of magnetic field lines, or you can call it magnetic flux. So the value of electric current will also decrease, and at this level again magnetic field line will come and collide here. Zero magnetic field line will pass through this ring, so the value of electric current will again be zero. Okay, understood? Now we have come from here to here. Now I'm not stopped here, I'm again going to rotate it, but this time it is in opposite direction. Firstly we have started from here and we come here. Okay, now I'm going to rotate it into this direction, so it is opposite to the first one which we have discussed right now. Again I'm going to increase the value of magnetic field lines which are passing through this, so the value of current will be increased, but in opposite direction. So here it is also increasing, and the same thing will happen here. Again the value of electric current will go to the maximum level, and again it will come to the zero level, and the same thing will be repeated after. Okay, so this graph will tell you about the current produced by this generator. So what we have discussed then, that if we rotate our armature into this magnetic field like this, so the value of electric current will be increased into this armature, and it will be showed by this galvanometer. And if we put a graph, if we plot a graph of this AC generator, it will look like this. So we can say that this generator is working as AC generator. The graph is showing that the value of current and the direction of the current is changing at every moment. That is why this type of current is called AC current, and the device which produces AC current is called AC generator. Okay, so this was our video which in which we have discussed about this AC generator, and as your request it was in English, because your request was awesome. And if I tell you something that I'm not good, not so well in English, so it is my first video in English. I hope there are too many mistakes I have made here, but it was my first time. I will repeat it. I will regain myself, and definitely a day will come when I will be able to teach everything in English. So thank you so much to Mr. Yuvraj Singh, who have appealed to teach this topic into English, and it is my first time, and definitely I will increase my strength for you. That's all about this. Thank you so much for watching. If you like the video, then please share it with your friends, and your friend will share it more and more, and this will increase my strength definitely. So this is time to say goodbye. Take care. Jai Hind, Vande Mataram.